There's plenty of passion and noise in these change rooms, but it's been a hard and long season for the Rosebery-Toorak Hawks.
The one at Sheffield, we got beat by nearly 500 points. That wasn't much fun.
With a severe shortage of players, many have to double up, playing both seniors and reserves games to avoid forfeiting. But they'd rather cop a 60-goal loss than not have a club at all.
Oh, no, it'd be no good. It'd be ghost town.
Marcus Goodson remembers the glory days in Rosebery.
98 and 99, played in 2000 grand finals. So, good 90s were good to us.
But the town's population is shrinking and player numbers aren't what they used to be. Changes at the Rosebery mine haven't helped either.
The roster they got, you see, 7-7's made it even worse.
The club survives on the unwavering dedication of its volunteers.
Got too old and got a knee replacement, so I couldn't play anymore. My best thing is to keep in touch and umpire.
Duncan Murfitt is the senior coach, secretary and treasurer, and he still pulls on the boots.
Too old and played too many. I think that sums it up. But yeah, no, over 450 here at Rosebery-Toorak. I love the town. Really love the footy club.
The team has little chance of winning a game this season. Kicking a goal is hard enough.
Most of our players come off and pat each other on the back and, yeah, we did our best. And that's winning in itself, or that's success for them.
Despite the club's lack of on-field success, it remains the heartbeat of the small town, a chance for people to forget about work and catch up for a few hours. For 20 years, Christy Fallows has been volunteering in the canteen.
I was up till midnight last night and then back up here at 6 this morning to get everything ready.
She's lived in Rosebery for 41 years and couldn't imagine the town without the club.
That'd be horrible if there was no football.
And it would mean the next generation would have nowhere to play.
I definitely want them to be able to grow up and be a part of it and to play when they're older.
Clubs right across the northwest and the state are struggling with player numbers. It's prompted AFL Tasmania to announce a review into the state of football here, looking at how these clubs can survive for years to come.
Going back 20 or 30 years, there was 8 teams on the west coast. And now there's only 2. Hard decisions are going to have to be made by both clubs, associations and AFL Tas.
They've got to find a way to be able to level out the playing field for all these lesser clubs.
In the meantime, these blokes are waiting for the tide to turn.
Hopefully that will turn around. And clubs like ours can keep going for years.
And maybe a win will come sooner rather than later. Sean Wales, ABC News, Rosebery.